Inside this news tonight, a Republican state senator ramping up efforts to expel two lawmakers on the hot seat.
KCRA3's Mike Lurie joining us now with more on how this could actually add up to trouble for the Democrats.
That's right, Colson. This is really a math problem for the Democrats. They need 27 votes to maintain their supermajority in the Senate, but now they are at least one vote short.
Any debate or discussion?
On the Senate floor today, Joel Anderson was angling for a vote to expel two of his colleagues.
Senators are not above the law. And unfortunately, when you give them a paid vacation, you're sending a clear signal that you think it's okay. I don't.
Senator Ron Calderon is on a paid leave of absence, even though he's facing 24 felony corruption counts. Senator Rod Wright is also on paid leave, although he's already been convicted by a jury of 8 felonies for lying about where he lives. He's due to be sentenced in mid-May. Neither senator can vote, but both are collecting their $95,000 salaries.
There's absolutely nothing prohibiting them from returning at will and voting, and that's the problem.
But there was no Senate vote today, despite some rumblings from Republicans to suspend the two embattled senators.
We cannot suspend without pay, and so the leaves of absence assure that these two members are not going to be on the Senate floor. We're putting the Senate again before our supermajority.
The Democrats are now two members shy of a supermajority, which means they'll need Republican votes to raise taxes or pass a constitutional amendment. The latter could be problematic for Governor Brown, whose budget proposal calls for a constitutional amendment to strengthen California's rainy day fund, a reserve account for tough economic times. In the meantime, the offices of both Senator Calderon and Senator Wright are open for business.
Up here, they keep an office open so they can provide information when people call about bills.
And the next step comes on Wednesday before the Senate Rules Committee, and then depending on what happens, Senator Anderson may try to force a vote on Thursday.
Trying to put it on a fast track. Now, when you hear about people being expelled from the state Senate, some people may be wondering, has that even ever happened before?
It has happened, actually. You have to go all the way back to 1905. That's when it first happened. 4 senators were thrown out for malfeasance back then. More recently, 2 senators, Frank Hill and Joe Montoya, resigned in the 90s following an FBI sting exposing Capitol corruption. That caper was known as Shrimp Scam.
A long time ago. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you, Mike.